Right, good morning all of you. Two gear wheels mesh externally and are to give a velocity ratio of 3:1. The teeth are of involute form, module 6 millimeters, addendum 1 module, pressure angle 20 degrees. The pinion rotates at 90 rpm. Determine number of teeth on the pinion to avoid interference and the corresponding number of teeth on the wheel. The length of path of contact and length of arc of contact. And the third one is the number of pairs of teeth in contact. Right? Fourth one is maximum velocity of sliding. Right? Are you getting me? So, module is 6 millimeters, addendum is equal to 1, pressure angle is 20 degrees. Right? Now, N1, what is N1? RPM of the pinion is 90 RPM. Then you have to find out the minimum number of teeth on pinion to avoid interference. Similarly, minimum number of teeth to avoid interference. Length of path of contact, length of arc of contact, then contact ratio. That is equal to length of arc of contact ratio and velocity of sliding. Okay. Now, what is velocity ratio? Velocity ratio in terms of, right? The RPM's values are in terms of your diameter, circle diameters are in terms of number of teeth. Right? Velocity ratio is equal to number of teeth on, definitely gear is larger. So let us take a suffix 2 is per the gear and suffix 1 is per pinion. Suffix 1 is per pinion. Okay. Then number of teeth on gear is more. So more number divided by lesser number of teeth later, a positive value 3. Right? Or you can express N1 by N2. N1 by N2. Okay. Or in terms of it is similar to your number of teeth. D2 divided by D1. D2 divided by D1. What is D here? It's circle diameter. So module is given. Module is equal to 6 millimeters. And addendum is equal to 1 module. Okay. Angle is 20 degrees. Elevator system here. Now you can find out. First, so velocity ratio is equal to 3 by 1 or 3 is equal to N1 by N2. N1 by N2. Yes, you can find out the value of N2. Already N1 is given. What is N value? N is equal to N13. That is equal to 30 RPM. 30 RPM. Okay. Now from this, you can find out the angular velocity. Omega 1 is equal to, omega 1 is equal to 2 n by c. So 2 pi n by c. You can get a value in terms of radians per second. Right, similarly, omega 2 angular velocity of gear, 2 pi n by c. That is equal to radians per second. Okay, find out these values. Then, first step, in the step, you have to find out minimum number of teeth on pinion to avoid interference. Okay? Interference. So, what is the formula? Minimum number of teeth on pinion to avoid interference. You have the formula. Addendum quotient. Addendum quotient divided by. This formula? 1 plus G into G plus 2. Sin phi minus 1. You can find out 2AP divided by, there is small correction here, sin square pi minus 1. Okay. That is equal to, now you just substitute the values here. 2E2, what is addendum of pinion here? Addendum of pinion is equal to 1 module. Right? Module is 6. So 2E2 6. Divided by square root of 1 plus gear ratio is nothing but number of teeth on gear wheel divided by number of teeth on pinion. So that is equal to velocity ratio. That is equal to 3 here. 3 into 3 plus 2 sine square 20 degrees minus 1. Okay, then you just find out the value of number of teeth on gate, number of teeth on pinion. Similarly, you have to find out the value of T2. Once you have T1 value, you know the gear ratio or velocity ratio, right? If you want, you can mark G also, right? So T2 is equal to G into T1. Then the second one is, you need to find out length of path of contact. Length of path of contact. What is the formula to find out length of path of contact? LP is equal to length of path of approach. Path of approach plus length of path of recess. Length of path of recess. So this already we have expressed this as K into KL, that is equal to KP plus PL. KP plus PL, that is equal to, that is equal to, what is the length of path of approach? LPOA is equal to KP is equal to formula, addendum circle radius RA square plus R square cos square phi under root minus R sine phi. Okay, then you need to find out the value of R and RA. Right, here R is the circle radius. R is equal to, how do you find out R? You know the value of T1 here. You can write M T1 by 2. M is D by T. T, T cancel. You will get the D value. M T1 by 2 is R value. Then RA is equal to R plus addendum. Addendum circle radius is equal to the circle radius plus addendum. Then you will get these values in terms of millimeters. Right? Similarly, you find out the gear pitch circle radius capital R is equal to MT2 by 2 millimeters. Similarly, capital RA is equal to capital R plus addendum. So you will get these values. Right? Once you have these values, you just substitute here, then you will get length of path of approach and length of path of recess. Okay, then here we have already taken the equation for length of path of approach. Then length of path of recess is equal to PL. That's equal to RA square plus R square cos square phi minus capital R sine phi. Right? By using these two equations, you can find out length of path of approach and length of path of recess. Then LP is equal to, you just add these two. Length of path of approach plus length of path of recess, you will get in terms of millimeters. Right? Once we have length of path of approach, length of path of contact is equal to length of path of contact divided by cos phi. You get length of path of contact. Length of path of contact. Right? So this was the second step, right? Length of path of approach and length of path of recess. First you calculate. If you add these two, you get length of path of contact. Once we have length of path of contact, you just substitute here in this equation, you will get length of arc of contact. So from this, you can find out third parameter. What is the third one you need to find out? Contact ratio, right? Number of teeth, pairs of teeth in contact. So to find out this, you have to contact ratio. Contact ratio is equal to length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. So this LA value already calculated in our previous step. And what is the circular pitch? Circular pitch is nothing but pi m. LA divided by pi into module. So you will get number of pairs of teeth in contact. Number of pairs of teeth in contact. Okay. So this is third step. And what is the last one? Maximum velocity of sliding. How do you get velocity of sliding? Velocity of sliding, you will get it from the sum of the angular velocities of both pinion and gear. Gear is, let us assume pinion is rotating in a clockwise sense and the gear is rotating in the anti-clockwise sense, then the total angular velocity is the cause of sliding. That's why fourth one is equal to velocity of sliding, Vs maximum. Maximum velocity of sliding is equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 into length of path of approach. So R omega formula, right? Vs maximum is equal to R omega, right? This is omega, R is length of path of approach. This we already calculated here. Okay, so later you convert this into meters per second. Okay. So I hope it is clear.